Dictation number SV180 TN001. Get ready. Start. I am grateful to you for giving me this opportunity to intervene in this debate at this stage to say a few words on behalf of the government. Those honorable members who have already spoken have been so exceedingly kind and gentle in regard to our policy that there is very little that I need say in defense of it. The main thing is, after all, the objectives and trends of our policy. As far as I have been able to make out, there is a very great deal of agreements in this house in regard to these. So I must express my gratitude to this house for its kind reception to this subject. It is not an easy matter to speak about a subject which is as broad as the world and which involves many difficult problems. Sir, there was a reference to external publicity. I confess that I am not satisfied with it. I am not satisfied with it for a variety of reasons. First of all, it is inadequate because of financial and such like reason. Secondly, the personnel is not quite so trained or satisfactory as we would want it to be. Honorable members who referred to this said two things which are self-contradictory. On one side, they said that the persons in charge of our external publicity should be experts in India's background, history, culture, etc. I agree, we certainly would like to have those persons. They also said that those persons should be trained journalists. Now, normally, these two qualities are not to be found in one person. In addition to them, special and specific qualities relating to a particular country they may serve in are also necessary. Thus, the choice of officers for external publicity is no doubt a difficult affair. But then, what is the test of external publicity? The ultimate test is whether your country rises in status in the councils of the world or in international affairs. That is the general test. Today, India may be heavily criticized by those countries who do not approve of India's policies. Nevertheless, at no time in the past was the importance and status of India greater than it is today. The fact remains that progressively our status in world affairs has gone up and our voice counts whether it is liked or disliked. It is so not because our external publicity is good or bad, but because of other factors. I think you expect too much from our representative abroad if you think that he could influence a whole country by some pamphlets. He can only emphasize what our general policy is and bring it to the notice of other countries. He cannot convince them if they do not want to be convinced. He has to function within the orbit of our general policy. If that general policy is not approved by other governments or by public opinion in the other countries, then it is not his fault. The responsibility is with us. As regards foreign possession in India, some honorable members wanted us to issue the ultimatum. This is not the right way. Apart from that, it is not a very realistic way of looking at things. One does not go about in this complicated world issuing ultimatums. Our policy in regard to the foreign possession has been this. First of all, it is perfectly clear that India cannot tolerate any footholds of foreign powers in this country. So far as the people are connected, we want to get them an opportunity to live their own lives and to have autonomy to decide their own internal fate. Because they have the background of many years of history and certain culture of their own, we do not wish to interfere with it. That is not our government's policy, even though some individuals might talk about it. I do not wish to say much about the major questions in the world. The House knows that the foreign ministers of certain important countries are meeting in Europe so long as people discuss these matters round the conference table. There is always hope of some solution. It may not be a final solution, but at any rate, it will avert war. Honorable members referred to the fact that the Union Jack was hoisted over the Parliament building some days ago. 2 or 3 years ago, this matter was discussed and we decided that as a matter of courtesy, we would allow the Union Jack to be hoisted over one of our important official buildings on a certain day in the year. This decision was not the result of a request, but simply a matter of courtesy. At that time, there was no question of flying the flag on Parliament House since Parliament was not sitting. When I saw the flag on Parliament House, I was myself a little surprised. It seems that the instructions given 2 years ago were not properly understood by the person in charge and hence the mistake. While it is right for us to show courtesy, I feel that no flag but the Indian flag should be flown over Parliament House and instructions have been issued to that effect. I should now like to express my gratitude and only for what the honorable members have said about of policy, but for the patience with which they have listened to me. Stop.